Disturbing accusations against a Southwest Florida teacher. Carol Pauls is accused of shoving two paper towels down the throat of a special needs student.
Two teacher aides in the classroom finally pulled her away, and she's now facing aggravated child abuse charges. NBC2's Tim Ronka is live at Nacatee Elementary School in DeSoto County.
Kelly, as you can imagine, many parents we spoke to today were shocked to hear about this. They were also angry because the school did not tell them about it first. And for those that know this teacher, they say it does sound very out of character.
Grueling details listed in an arrest report saying Carol Pauls held down a student with special needs and shoved two paper towels down his throat, only stopping when two teacher's aides pulled the boy away.
That's crazy. I mean, you shouldn't have people like that working in a school, especially with children like.
But parent Elsie Whitaker knows the teacher and says she finds it hard to believe.
She has a good standing with other students. I've never had a problem with her. I'm even shocked with the statement that this would ever happen, especially with her.
The teacher's neighbors in Port Charlotte were stunned.
Of course it's concerning. No child should have this done to them.
Pauls was arrested Thursday afternoon at the school for an incident that is now also under investigation by the Department of Children and Families.
How do you send your child to school knowing they're going to be safe from like that? You've got to worry about other kids bringing guns and knives. Now you have to worry about teachers.
The superintendent tells me as soon as they learned of the incident, they suspended the teacher. But many fellow parents are angry that they were never told.
My daughter's in the same grade. I'm here practically every day. I'm a mother that volunteers.
The teacher told deputies when she was questioned that the child had actually bit her finger that she was holding a paper towel in, and that's how it ended up there. We also understand that she also didn't tell deputies that that was going to be the problem. We went to her home today, and her husband told us that he wouldn't comment at this time. The child right now is not back at school. Live in DeSoto County, Tim Bronca, NBC2.